Good afternoon and welcome along to Future Stars for Building Academy Australia. Huge show coming up. Brendan Goddard will join us live in the studio. Lachie Neal, what is his future like at the Fremantle Footy Club? And can the Blues land Dylan Shiel? Cal Toomey is our AFL draft expert. He's along for the ride. Cal, welcome.
G'day, Kane. Welcome aboard, mate. Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Obviously, Brownie couldn't make it. But big day tonight for the TAC Cup. The Morris Medal will be crowned later on this evening. Sam Walsh, the raging favourite, to take that one out to just add to a growing CV.
And the AFL Games record holder along for the ride, as always, Boomer Harvey.
Yeah, good to be here, Kane. Brownie, what's he doing? He gave you a bit of stick the other week.
I missed the show and I copped it, so he's missed one. He deserves it as
well. Yeah, we'll get into him through
the show. Hey, by the way, just quickly, Boomer kicked a miraculous goal today, coming with a bounce in his yesterday. Local footy, one of the greats.
Do we have vision?
We might.
We might track down that vision, but right now let's get into the Kangan Institute Trade Centre. Kangan Institute, bound to industry, bound to succeed. Visit kangan.edu.au. Lachie Neal, reports emerge this week that he did meet with Brisbane during the year. How concerned should Fremantle be?
Very, very concerned. It looks like it's a real go, this one. And something that's really exciting for the Lions, I think, guys, because finally they're at a place now where not only are they keeping their players, but players want to go there. We saw that last year with Luke Hodge and Charlie Cameron. Lachie Neal's the next one now who's been targeted by them, offered a long-time deal. I think that's the right way to go. He's the perfect fit for them, Boomer. I think he's 25, adds to a growing midfield.
25, I actually thought he was a little bit older than that. Kane, you probably help me out. When do you reckon your prime of your football career is?
Yeah, I think it's probably between 26 and 28. I mean, we can ask BJ about that, but he's still playing some pretty good footy into his 30s.
So I would have said the same. I would have said 26 to 29. He's a great fit. What did I have to give up for him, Cal?
I think it has to be their first pick, and I'd be happy to do that if I was the Lions. Which is pick four, which will turn to pick five once the compensation pick comes in for Tom Lynch. And at that point, you never know what you're going to get at that point, but I think at this point in their development, the Lions, they can add an A-grader to their midfield. They've got a couple coming through. They don't need another younger player. We look at their list, they've got those guys. So Fremantle as well, it might benefit them because they've already got an early selection as well. So then they go for the King boys.
Well, I was going to ask you, because they've been on the hunt. They've tried for key position players for probably 5 or 6 years. Is this their one opportunity? Do they let him go?
I think they should do now. They've offered him a long-term deal. The reports are overnight that they've come to the party now and said, we really want you to stay. Here's a four-year deal and have a think about that one. But if he wants out, it's the right one to go.
I think it's a win-win for both clubs. I think it's a fantastic trade.
There you have it. Get involved on social media. Would you do it, Fremantle fans, Brisbane fans? Also, Mitch McGovern's the other one who has confirmed that he is leaving Adelaide. Now, Carlton appears to be the club after him. Once again, what's he worth and what would Adelaide accept considering he's got 2 years to go?
We've spoken about him a bit on the show this year, haven't we, Boomer?
Yeah,
67 goals from 48 games. So he's not a proven talent yet in terms of his goal kicking. It's not a great average per game, but certainly he's a guy who could be a match winner going forward. He's played in defence as well. If the Blues do get a mid-round priority pick, I think that's the right pick, about that pick 11 or 12 range. I think you just do the deal at that point and make it happen, but it's still up in the air whether they do get
that. Have we got word on the priority pick yet, though?
No,
mid or is it end?
They fronted the commission this week and sort of put forward their case in the AFL and make a call in grand final week.
How highly do you rate him, Boomer? Mitch McGovern.
Look, I don't know, Kane, because he averages 11 possessions a game. And he's just over, I think he's 1.2 goals per game. I don't think it's a superstar. The other week we mentioned he's got the same stats as Josh Bruce from St Kilda. Now, I don't think they'll be doing that trade for a pick, for a priority pick. So it's a tough one. I don't know if he's overrated, but he's a player that's required and needed for a key position to hold down a big spot. But I wouldn't be giving too much away for him.
What's it mean for the Crows, Kane, to lose another player? They do this every year, it seems.
Yeah, they do. It's a concern for them, particularly ones that they've plucked late in the draft. Like McGovern's a pick in the 40s, so they've done well to get him and then to break a contract and leave like Lever was out of contract. But no, there's some concerns at Adelaide in the fallout this week. We'll continue on. Jordan Ruffhead met with West Coast during the week. Now, it appears that Scott Lysett might leave the Eagles and Ruckman are in demand.
Yeah, I don't mind this one for the Eagles. I mean, he hasn't had a great year and obviously only averaged 12 hitouts and 12 disposals a game in the 12 games that he did play for the Dogs. But I don't mind it from the perspective of the Eagles because he can add some defensive backup as well. So he's going there as a backup. I think we all know that. Nick Nat will miss next year as well with injury. So he goes over there. Eric McKenzie's nearing the end of his career. So to provide some defensive cover, I think.
I think he's a better backman than he is a ruckman. Mm. I think he's a makeshift ruckman at best. But if he goes there and they lose Lysett, yes, he can play in defence. And then if they need it, he can play for
in the ruck as well. And comes for nothing as well. He's a restricted free agent, so the Dogs won't match that one. The Eagles don't have to give up too much to get him.
If you're looking for a rewarding career in the electrical, plumbing, construction or engineering industry, enrol in a pre-apprenticeship with the Kangan Institute. Apply at kangan.edu.au or call 13 Kangan. Kangan Institute, bound to industry, bound to succeed. Now, some or all of the training is delivered with Victorian and Commonwealth Government funding. RTO number 3077. Massive show still to come. Can the Blues land Dylan Shiel? Cow's going to tell us that. But up next, the Essendon and St Kilda superstar is live in the studio. Brendan Goddard to join us next. Welcome back to Future Stars. All thanks to the Builders Academy. Become a registered building legend with Builders Academy Australia. Visit buildersacademy.com.au. Well, a few weeks ago on this program, we had a look at the journey with Brendan Goddard and Advanced Hair. Let's have a look.
Today, we're at the Melbourne Zoo with my family. Meant to be for just the kids, but I think the adults enjoy it just as much as the kids. I'll encourage my daughters to play football if they feel like they want to. Probably my preference is to play other sports, and one being golf, being an avid golfer, but if that's what they wanted to do, I'd be happily support them in their decision.
So a magnificent career comes to an end for Brendan Goddard.
I don't necessarily agree with the increasing of the draft age. I can kind of see both sides of the argument, but in my opinion, I've had a great experience from it. Being drafted, albeit in year 11 and having to finish school, it was a great thing for my development to be drafted at such a young age, and I think it's really helped further down the track in my career and fast-track my development. The advanced hair treatment's going well. It's easy to do, doing it from the comfort of my own home with semi-regular checkups through Advanced Hair Studio in Melbourne, so it's going well at the minute.
Brendan can come across very passionate on the field, and it can be misconstrued. Well, not misconstrued, it can come across that he's a very grumpy person. He's just so super competitive, but when we're at home, he's actually reasonably calm. He's really good at separating his footy life to his family life and home life. He's actually quite manageable at home.
My wife is happy. We both agreed that it was, if we can do it now, why not? So, and hopefully have a full wet hair for the rest of my life.
There are some players that are jealous of my progression with advanced hair and my treatment. Probably Josh Green springs to mind. Tom Bell Chambers is another. There's also a few staff that are very interested in the results and ask a lot of questions. The reality is, being a 33-year-old, I'm well aware of the situation, and I'd hope, like everyone, that I could play forever, but the reality is all good things must come to an end.
Brendan Goddard is live at the McCafe studio with Advanced Hair founder Carl. How, BJ, how is retirement life, or is it retirement
life? Well, yeah, semi-retirement, but just settling to the off-season now, so practically a stay-at-home dad. I've encouraged my wife, Rosie, to go back to work, and I'll take care of the kids at home, so settling in quite nice at the minute.
What's the state of play at the moment, Brendan? Are you going to speak to clubs? Are you going to look at playing on next year?
I'm really not sure, Cal, to be honest. The main reason I didn't announce my retirement, I just felt like I wasn't ready to make a decision. I had 2 or 3 days to kind of sum everything up and gather my thoughts. So there wasn't really a hidden agenda behind anything. So, and that's not to say that I'll contemplate playing on or I won't. I really don't know what I will do, but I'm fair to say that I'll keep the door ajar at this stage.
I think John Worsfold said it was a jolt for you, that conversation. Can you describe the shock, or just that moment when you realised that you won't be at the Bombers next year?
There's this deep emptiness, I guess. And as much as I prepared for that moment to kind of hear those words come out of Woosher or the club's mouth, it's looking back on it, there's nothing that could have prepared me the way I felt and when I heard the words. So, Boomer, having gone through the same experience last year, when you feel like you've got more to give and your body and your mind's in a really good space, it's actually a harder pill to swallow, because I said I'd wish my body was failing me and I was struggling to get through the season, but reality is I wasn't. So, yeah, it was a pretty tough thing to hit.
BJ, have you had that opportunity to put your head on the pillow at night and picture yourself in another jumper, or which teams that you would like to go to if you're going down that track?
Yeah, not really. That's a good question. No, I haven't, to be honest, because I was fully intent on playing on next year, and that was for the Essendon Footy Club. So, although I had to start thinking about it potentially, I couldn't picture myself playing for anyone else.
Is there one particular team that appeals? Is it the Premiership, or are you prepared to rebuild with, say, a Carlton like Luke Hodges done at Brisbane?
Well, I've first probably got to just, one, someone's got to be interested, but two, decide whether I want to play on or not. So I haven't really gone through those first two stages. So I'm not in a position to kind of think about that. But if someone comes knocking, I'll sit down and then start weighing up my options. But at this point, there's nothing really to tell.
How close do you think the Bombers are? There's different views on whether it was a wasted year, a failed year, didn't make the finals after making the top eight last year. What's your take on how close they are to a premiership assault?
Oh, I think they're well on their way. When I say they, it sounds weird already to myself, but we're definitely on the right track. So clearly the start of the year really let us down in the latter part, but I just felt towards the end of the year, we obviously finished off well, but our footy and our brand and the way we're playing, the way we talk, train, it was different. And although we did make the finals last year, I didn't feel that confident going into finals to know what we're going to get from the group. So that's the pleasing thing, and that's why it feels different. And people want to reflect on our first half of the year, which is disappointing, but we're definitely, and because it's in the present, our last half of the year just felt different. So by all means, we feel like it wasn't a wasted year at all.
And Carl Howe is the founder of Advanced Hair. Carl, how did the partnership with Brendan come about?
Well, Brendan is a good friend of Warnie's, and Warnie's always been saying to me, "Why don't you go and do something with Brendan?"
Will he's you? Always been heckling me.
Yeah, he's so. Then it just came about, and we started the treatment. About 4 months ago.
Yeah, 3 or 4 months ago.
And I've been in Europe, and I only saw the results this week, but they're very good.
And you're happy,
very good.
You're happy
for
such a
short
results?
Period of time. Oh yes, definitely.
You two have got nothing to worry about. Carl, you might have to come visit Carl and Ol.
See you in a couple of years. Yeah. Your shout.
Carl, I'm actually struggling up top if the camera goes behind. I'm in some strife. Guys, thanks so much for coming in. Carl, you don't go away empty-handed. You've got the magnificent prize pack that we give away on Future Stars, the Dometic 43-litre icebox valued at $239. Dometic Mobile Living Made Easy. Thanks to McCafe, a $50 McCafe voucher. Head in to try the new taste of McCafe's 100% Arabica beans. McCafe, where coffee people, and the Parkview Hotel. Rediscover the Melbourne Parkview from $169 per couple. Guys, thanks so much for stopping by. Speaking of Advanced Hair, let's take a look at the recruit of the week. All thanks to Australia's largest and renowned hair restoration clinics, scientifically proven medically backed hair loss treatments. Who else but this man, Jaden Stevenson, the Rising Star winner?
Yeah, and absolutely the deserved Rising Star winner, I think, from most accounts. Look, he was outstanding this year. Kicked 34 goals and changed the way Collingwood played, Boomer. I think he stepped into their forward line and just gave such energy and speed up there and looked so confident from day one.
Well, I actually didn't think that their unorthodox forward line would work, Cal, to be honest with you. They had all those mediums, DeGoey, Stevenson, as you mentioned, Thomas.
Yep, Hoskin-Elliott.
And I didn't think it would work, but for a young guy to come in his first year of AFL football, and kicked 35 goals, I think it was, or 34, yeah. I think you might have said, was unbelievable. So a great start to his career.
What an absolute star. Stay with us on Future Stars. Up next, Cal Toomey goes under the microscope with his under-18 Team of the Year. You are watching Future Stars, all thanks to the Builders Academy Australia. Cal Toomey is in position at the Plasma for his under-18 Team of the Year. What do you got for us today, mate?
Just one change today, guys. And look, it's a pretty hard team to break into at the moment. It's a pretty standard side that's been there for a long time. These guys have performed well across the whole year. So only one change. Xavier O'Halloran, the Western Jets midfielder and Vic Metro captain, comes into the side for Tom McKenzie, Northern Knights halfback, who was knocked out yesterday. We're home for the Knights, so he's out.
You've got one Northern Knights boy in there and you take him out of the team.
Yeah, I know you've got your allegiances with the Knights, but they were pretty ordinary yesterday, knocked out of the TAC Cup, so he's gone as well. Look, Xavier Halloran's a good player, inside midfielder, gets the ball really well in there. What I want to talk about, though, is Jordan Clark, because he's been fantastic across the second half of the season. Comes from a cricket background. He played for Australia's under-16 cricket team in Pakistan a couple of years ago, but has come on the radar of AFL clubs this year. He's played some senior footy for Claremont, just uses the ball really well out of half-back. So has got some size on him and uses the ball, as I said, with precision from that spot. And that's what you need for those guys. I think that he could overtake Ian Hill as being the best first player picked out of WA this year. So that's such has been his form across the second half of the season.
Taron Thomas, is he still in the mix for that NGA Academy pick for North Melbourne?
Look, he'll go to North Melbourne, I think, if a bid comes after the first dozen or so. But His form hasn't been great this year. He played in the VFL last week, only got a handful of touches. And look, I think they have cooled on him a little bit because his form in the second half of the year has been pretty average. But look, he's still a really talented player and spent a lot of time with them. So I think he does go to North, but a little bit later on than first expected.
And one that I've been pushing for most of the year is young Connor Thar from the Western Jets.
Yeah.
Any improvement in the young fella?
Yeah, he's been terrific across the whole year. One of the more consistent players in the TSC Cup and has been very unlucky to miss out on this side again. Could only fit one of the Jets boys in today.
It's only 22 weeks in a row he's missed out, Kane, but
he's the next in. Look, he's playing for the Western Jets at the moment, right now actually in the TSC Cup finals. So a couple of those guys will elevate themselves over the next few weeks. But as I said, most of these guys have had their consistent seasons. Bailey Smith's been missing a little bit off late. Sam Walsh I watched yesterday for the Geelong Falcons start again. And Ned McHenry probably played one of the best games I've seen him play as well in the TSC Cup. So a really good side here and pretty confident.
In a word, Walsh still number one?
Yes. I think he's just the standout player and the obvious pick. And you don't mess around with pick one. And I think that is the obvious choice. Now, guys, time for the Multicultural Player of the Week for Tobin Brothers Funerals, Celebrating Lives. And Christian Petrarca, guys, do you think it could be a difference for the D's on Friday night? Because he has all the star factor of a finals player.
Well, I think, Boomer, he gives them what they don't have, that outside speed, class to finish in front of goal. They've got the Bulls inside with Brayshaw, Oliver, and if Viney comes back, this guy, forward of centre, gives him that class, doesn't he?
Kane, he's played 60 games for 56 goals. I actually think he can go to another level.
Yep.
I think he's very important, like you just mentioned. Yes, he is that X factor, but I think he can go to another level. And if he can improve, he can be nearly one of the best players in the competition because of his body size and the way he can just win inside ball and get outside, like you mentioned.
How'd you go in your first final?
Yesterday, we had a win.
No, I was talking about your first final,
yeah,
because
okay.
It will be Christian's first. How was yours? Would have been way back
final,
in 96.
97, Kane. 97. So I got dropped for the finals in 96 and one game.
What about you? How'd you go?
Nah, terrible.
No good?
Six possessions.
I can't remember my first final, to be honest with you.
Ever played. That was the Multicultural Player of the Week. All thanks to Tobin Brothers Funerals, Celebrating Lives. On the other side of this, we'll tell you, can the Blues land a big fish in Dylan Shear? Have a look at that. You can't quite see it. The vision doesn't do it justice, but that's our man, Boomer Harvey, just taking it out of the ruck and snapping an amazing goal. What are you doing rucking in the first place?
Well, I actually didn't. We just spoke about this. Is that actually a hit out?
I'm not sure.
I was in the ruck. Nobody else nominated. I put my little hand up and the other ruckman wasn't there. And I just kicked it out of midair and it went through.
Always been a very clever footballer. Now time to get into the trade predictor for Sheen Panel Services. When the unexpected happens on the road, choose Sheen Panel Service as your repairer. Sheengroup.com.au. Dylan Shiel won't go away in this trade period. Contracted to the Giants for next year. But some talk he'll come back to Melbourne. Let's start with the Bombers, because they're very keen.
They're very keen, and I think we'll get an answer from Dylan Shiel pretty soon after the Giants season as to what they do. But we've come up with this one on the predictor. Essendon's 2018 first-round pick, which at the moment is pick 8, but likely to become pick 9, plus their first-round pick next year. So the Bombers will be hoping they make finals and go deep into September next year. So that'll be around 14, hopefully, for their sake.
There is a reason why we're talking about Dylan Shiel, isn't it? Because salary cap issues are coming into it for the GWS Giants.
They need to clear out some money. And he's on a lot, and he's a good player, and next year he's a free agent. So they could strike now and get something good for him while they can. So they could get two first-rounders. Do you think that's about right for Dylan Shiel? Do you think it's too much?
Yeah, I think it's probably not enough. When you look at Lever getting two first-round draft picks from Adelaide to Melbourne, I think Shiel is a better prospect than Lever.
Is there an argument to say they paid a little bit overs for Lever, so, you know, two for Shiel is about right?
Potentially, and if they're looking to clear salary cap space, hey, Boomer, this is the Blues. I'd love to get him.
Oh, they certainly would. I think that's exactly what they lack. Carlton's number one pick. Kane, I'm pretty strong on this one, and I'm glad that you said Sam Walsh will go number one before Cal. It's a big no for me. Sam Walsh has got 8 years on Dylan Shiel. Mm. It's just a no. If you're a Carlton supporter, trust me on this one, and it's a no.
I'm a big fan of Sam Walsh, as you know. He was on the show last week, spoke brilliantly, and future captain and all the rest. Played 200 games. But there's still an unknown that he's going to do it. Not every draft pick happens and works out. So with Dylan Shiel, you at least know what you're getting from a Blues perspective. They need to be better sooner. And I'm not sure Sam Walsh is going to have that impact straight away. He will be a good player long term, so that's where they've got to think about it.
The last club we want to take a look at is the Saints. Is there a possibility that Shiel could end up at the Saints?
Well, I mean, the Saints are into everyone, aren't they? And they have to land some at some point. But at this stage, I don't think the Saints would be first on his sort of agenda because they seem a long way off. We've come up with this one. Jack Billings' name won't go away either. I don't think anyone's safe at the Saints if the right offer's there for them. Jack Billings was a top 3 pick in 2013. And we've thrown in next year's first rounder as well for the Saints. The only worry for this one is the Saints could be a bottom four club again next year. Mm. So in that case, they'd be giving up Jack Billings, pick three, and a top four pick. So that's a lot to give up for Dylan Shiel. We know he's a game breaker. We know what he can do. But if you're the Saints, would you do that one?
I don't know about... I don't think I would. I think, like you said, there's nobody safe at St Kilda, so they throw up a lot of names. I would be looking at Jack Billings plus another player, potentially, and keeping next year's number one
pick. We want you to get involved in social media. We've got a poll up on our Twitter account, at FutureStarsTV. Which club is more likely to land Shiel? There it is. Is it Carlton, Essendon, St Kilda or other? That's the way the votes sit at the moment.
Other might be coming with a bit of a rush because we all hear about the Hawks talk, about them going after a key midfielder and Dylan Shiel maybe in their sights. So maybe they're in the other bracket.
Cal, can GWS lose Dylan Shiel and potentially another player for salary cap issues?
Well, Will Setterfield with things on the way out, so at least there's some room spare there, but they have to make some move for sure.
Massive final series coming up. Let's take a look at it. The Toyota AFL final series. It's here next weekend. If there's anything, one thing recent final series have shown us, it's that anything can happen. Don't miss your chance to be there and witness it. Head to finals.afl for tickets starting from just $35. Guys, jam-packed program. Thanks for your company, but looking forward to the finals next week.
Yeah, absolutely.
Good to have you on, Cam.
Thank you. Nathan Brown will be back in the host chair next week doing it all again. You boys can get stuck into him and hopefully Boomer can kick another goal of the year and we have that vision a bit clearer for you next week. Thanks for joining us. To all the dads out there, have a magnificent Father's Day to you guys, both dads.
Yes.
Yep, enjoy the day with your family.
For my dad. Yeah. For my dad, I'm not a dad.
Have a great day.
Cow.